Hello, I'm Dr. Taban Alphonse, the CEO of a registered non-profit organization called Doorsteps Mobile Clinics Limited, an organization seeking support of €27,000 to help the development and implementation of a multi-sectoral project aimed at addressing the crisis that will follow COVID-19 in Uganda and specifically in West Nile, but also address the TB challenges that exist in the region. And this is by helping members to rear chicken, which will then be sold to help them enroll into a community health insurance scheme. And the community health insurance scheme will help the members to strategically purchase health services that will be of quality and equitable in nature to cater for both the vulnerable and well-to-do families of West Nile. Now, West Nile region has 34.9% people living below $1 per day, and 76% of these people living below $1 per day are actually in the rural areas of West Nile. Now, COVID-19 presents special challenges to include malnutrition, because families are not able to purchase the food items they needed because of the lockdown. But also, we've noted that the stigma that follows being suspected of COVID-19 is actually high, and communities reject people who have been suspected. And because of this, we are getting more mental health disorders, including depression, post-traumatic stress disorders, anxiety disorders, but also the cases of malnutrition are increasingly in the region. The government of Uganda responded to COVID-19 pandemic by a lockdown in March 2020. The lockdown was aimed to contain the spread of the COVID-19 from person to person, but it did not have a comprehensive strategy to cater both COVID-19 and what will happen after COVID-19, and therefore hundreds of families could not afford a meal per day. It had to distribute food rations, but the food rations could only take up to 1 week. But March was a season when people normally plant food items, and because of all this, the number of malnutrition now in West Nile has gone high. The number of people dying because of non-COVID illnesses have also gone high. The number of health conditions that are associated with malnutrition, including TB, including AIDS among people who are HIV infected, has also been on the increase. But also, there are other conditions that we are seeing people now dying from more, including complications of labor, including malaria in the region. And therefore, the region has already been hit hard by COVID-19 and could even get worse. West Nile has a long stretch border with South Sudan and Congo. These borders are still very porous, and health specialists in Uganda are projecting increased cases of COVID-19 because of these transmissions from the neighboring countries. In fact, the health economists project the effect of COVID-19 to last beyond 2020, and that means more people are going to enter poverty. In just 2 months in Uganda, more than 700 people have already slipped below the poverty line. They can barely afford basic health needs, including health care. There is hope, and we call to you all people of goodwill for humanitarian aid towards the development of Doorstep Mobile Clinic and Doorstep's Community Health Insurance Scheme. By donating to this cause, you will not only save thousands of lives in West Nile and Uganda overall, but also you will help to develop a robust system that is capable of addressing challenges and health needs and challenges of livelihood in West Nile and Uganda for very many years to come. So I want to thank you so much for the support and for the donation towards the development of this multi-sectoral project aid to address post-COVID-19 crisis and TB in West Nile. Thank you.